I'm Breeze Newell, and you're watching The Boss Company Presents. How I Learned the Fundamentals. DISC. Good morning, good afternoon, or good evening. No matter what time of day this video finds you, I hope it finds you well. Breeze here with The Boss Company. We provide customized consulting for businesses and individuals who have the willingness to believe, the desire to grow, and the courage to make it all happen. We're here to foster a habitual vision of greatness in all that we encounter, and we're here to serve. It is morning time for me. I have my morning coffee, which means I am ready to talk to you about how I learn the fundamentals about DISC, personality assessment. Here we go. Okay, what is DISC? DISC is a personality assessment that was developed in 1928 by a physiological psychologist out of Harvard. His name was Dr. William Moulton Marston. He actually wrote a book called Emotions of Normal People, and it's really evolved over time. It's used by lots and lots of businesses. It's used in psychology. It's used in universities. It's used across HR departments. It's really a way to psychologically evaluate and generalize people into groups based on their personality. Now with DISC, just like any personality profile, of course, it's a hasty generalization. People don't often fit specifically into the exact mold that they're categorized in, but it is a pretty good overview generally of where people fall. The reason it's called DISC is there's four different types. The D in DISC stands for dominance. That's about 17% of the population. It's actually the second least common type in society. The next letter is I. That's for influential. It's actually the most common DISC type. It's about 38% of the population. After that comes S. That's for steadiness. It's the second most common. It's about 32% of the population. And then last but not least, the C in DISC stands for conscientious. It's the least common. It's about 13% of the population. Let's actually go through these one by one. All right, so let's actually start with D on the DISC. This is the second least common DISC type. Like I was saying, it's 17% of the population. Ds on the DISC are typically exactly how it sounds, dominant. So these are oftentimes your high-level managers, your lawyers, your doctors, your entrepreneurs. You don't have to be a D on the DISC to be any of those things, but it is very common that if you do encounter people with those vocations, they are a D on the DISC. Now, dominant people are often very competitive. They can be daring. They can be bold. They can be decisive. They're usually going to make quick decisions. They're very results-oriented. Time is a huge factor for them. So when you're talking to a D on the DISC, those are usually the people that are very now. They don't really want to mess around with the details. It's not that the details aren't ultimately important to them, it's just they want to get to the point. Ds are often very blunt. Sometimes they violate boundaries. And so those people that you think of as like habitual line steppers that you deal with in business and in life that are just always saying something that you're just like, man, that is aggressive. Or I don't know if I would have put it that way. They're not usually overly concerned about offending people or hurting people's feelings. Now, the cool thing about that is when you're dealing with a D on the DISC, when you're interacting with a D on the DISC and talking to them, you have permission to act like them for the most part. They're not going to get offended if you're super blunt. They're not going to get offended if you get to the point. They're actually going to prefer that you do those things. Maybe not offend them, but they're going to prefer some bluntness, some straightforwardness. They're going to like that you're not wasting their time. They're going to like that you acknowledge that their time is important and that it's valuable to them. And it actually makes it kind of easy to communicate with these folks. Now, the only thing to think about with the D on the DISC is sometimes they can seem pretty intimidating. They can be kind of the alphas in the room, right? They can not just be intimidating to interact with, maybe they can even appear kind of intimidating. They can look like the alpha. And so you have to understand that going into these interactions with them, they aren't trying to necessarily be that way. It's just their personality. And if you are able to interact with them on their level, mirror them, behave like them, you're going to earn their respect. If you're very submissive and intimidated, it's not that they're going to not enjoy interacting with you, but they are going to treat you in a way where it's very apparent that there's kind of an imbalance here, and it could screw up the interaction. Next on the list is eye on the disc. Those are your influencers. They are influential. This is 38% of the population. This is the most common type that you interact with in society. So, you know, 4 in 10 people, for the most part, you're running into out in public, in business, whether they be customers you're interacting with, employees, even just friends and family, they're going to be an eye on the disc. These are classically what you consider your extroverts, your charismatic, outgoing, life of the party. They like to be liked. They want to be liked. They want to be part of a team. They want to be part of a whole and a collective or a tribe. They aren't loners by any means. They're not going to push the envelope, and they're not going to act in a way where they go against the consensus necessarily either. They want to be popular. And with these people, they're very fun-loving. They're jovial. They're funny. Usually humor is a huge staple of an eye. And they're not shy. They're very willing to interact with you. They're very willing to interact with others. They're social butterflies. Now, with that, there are some attributes that can actually cause them to get in their own way a little bit. They're overly optimistic, delusionally so sometimes. That can work to people's advantage sometimes, but also it can hurt a little bit in the sense that, you know, you might be an eye and you have a bad quarter at work and it's a performance-based job. The way an eye would look at it is, man, it can't get any worse than this. See, they're optimistic, they're positive, they're very glass half full, but they're not necessarily always realistic, and that can be to their detriment at times. Eyes can also usually be a little bit disorganized. They're not always very detail-oriented. They like a lot of variety. They can get a little scatterbrained. So getting them to hone in and focus on a specific task or idea, usually they're more kind of jumping around quite a bit. Their brain works that way. They're just a little bit more abstract in their thinking. They're not people that are analyzing things and overanalyzing things and keeping lists. So you got to hone their focus. Next is S on the disc. This is for steadiness. These are your people that are just consistent and stable. This is the second most common disc type. It's 32% of the population. So about 3 in 10 people you run into in society are an S on the disc. S's do not like change. They like things to stay steady. They want things to be constant. They want to know the rules. They want to know the reason behind the rules. Yet you need to earn the trust of an S. They're not just going to instantly trust you. They can be a little bit more introverted oftentimes, maybe a little bit quieter. You might even say shy at times, but they're very polite. They're very considerate. They're very reliable. They're loyal. But you do need to earn that. And if you violate an S's trust, it's going to be challenging to earn that trust back. They're relaxed. They're patient. They're sincere. They can be a little bit predictable. And they like a steady environment. Last but not least is C on the disc. This is the rarest disc type. This is 13% of the population. So about 1 in 10 people you run into might be a C on the disc. C stands for conscientious. What that means is they're very thoughtful, sometimes overly so. They're sometimes kind of shy. They are overly analytical to the point that it's going to be paralysis by analysis at times, so they're slow to make decisions. They need to know all of the details. You know, they're going to do their research. They're not just going to fly by the seat of their pants. They're really, in a lot of ways, the opposite of an eye, in that eyes are very just outgoing, abstract thinkers. They like to just make decisions. They're emotional, whereas C's are very logical. sometimes to their detriment, overly so. A C on the disc is going to be a fact finder. The facts matter. Don't argue with a C about emotions or who they are as a person or anything like that. They care about data. They care about objective reality and logic. They are not into emotions and emotional arguments and things like that. Okay, so we know the four disc types, D, I, S, and C. We got dominant, influential, steadiness, and conscientious. Why is this important? How can this help you? Let's talk about this from a couple of different angles. Let's say that you're a customer service or a salesperson, and you're dealing with people day to day. It could be over the phone, it could be via email, it could be via text. You could be on Zoom calls with them, you could be in person, no matter what it is. If you're able to take some of the attributes that I've outlined just earlier about each of these disc types, and you're able to have that in your mind when you're dealing with folks day to day through any of those means that we just mentioned, and you're able to identify what they are, it's gonna guide your ability to interact with them properly. It's gonna help your communication. If you're dealing with a D, then you're going to know that time is super important to them. And so you need to acknowledge that to them, right? You need to respect that. You need to be proactive and tell them that you understand that time's important to them. You also need to not be easily offended if they're a little bit blunt. And it's gonna help you with your interaction with them. Let's talk about if you were dealing with an I on the disc as a salesperson or as a customer service rep. An I is gonna be super outgoing. They're gonna be talking a lot, maybe even about themselves, because they're just super excited about meeting people and talking about life and talking about their experiences and trying to get to know people. They're the rapport builders. You may not have to really crack through a wall with an I because they're just so extroverted. How about talking to an S? So you're a customer service rep, you're a salesperson, and you have the second most common disc type in front of you. You know, 3 out of 10 people are steadiness. They're an S. They're gonna seem a little bit shy. You might have to kind of break through the walls to build rapport with them a little bit to get them out of their shell. The most important thing with an S is you have to earn their trust. You're not gonna be able to just instantly bond with them like you are with an I. You're not going to have somebody that's trying to be dominant like you are with a D. You're going to have someone that might even seem a little bit aloof. They might seem like they're not super invested in what's going on just because they have a lot of emotions. They're just not showing it. And when you're talking to somebody like that, you need to make sure that you have really good commitment and consistency with the way you behave. If you tell them that you're going to do something, if you tell them you're going to call them back at a certain time, if you tell them that you're going to deliver on a certain expectation, whether it be a product that you're selling, whether it be even a customer service expectation, you told them that you would make sure that you were available next Wednesday between 3:15 and 3:45. If you remind them that you set that expectation and now you're fulfilling it, that's going to go a long way with an S, and it's going to help your interaction with them. Last but not least, we have our C's on the disc. So you're interacting with a C on the disc as a salesperson or a customer service rep, or you're even emailing back and forth with them. The dead giveaway that a C on the disc is interacting with you is that they're going to be so detail-oriented, it's almost going to be unbelievable. If you're a salesperson, those are the folks that walk in with a big old stack of research. You know, they have not just knowledge or facts about what they're purchasing from you. They have the evidence with them. They've brought it. So you can actually identify a C without even talking to them. And the key with these folks is that you have to understand the way their brain works. They need to know every little thing before they make a decision. These are the folks that tell you that they need to go home and sleep on it, and they really mean it. It doesn't mean that you can't overcome this, as long as you approach it properly, but they are going to be a little bit timid about just pulling the trigger on something. It is paralysis by analysis. The way that you can really help yourself with a C on the disc is just providing the data. Provide the facts, show them with data or analysis or something tangible that what you're saying is true. And then the same thing when you're a customer service rep with these folks, you don't want to try and fake it till you make it. They might even ask you some questions just to see what you know, because they're super logical and they don't want you to BS them. They don't want you to act like you know something, but you don't know something. Just go find the answer for them. That's all they're looking for. There's also a really important component to all of this, just from a work efficiency, leadership, even dealing with your coworkers and interoffice dynamics and things like that when it comes to DISCs. So if you know the DISC type of someone that you're the manager of, or maybe someone who's leading you and they're your boss or your manager, it's going to help your interactions with them tremendously too. You know, if you have a boss that's a D on the DISC and he's super blunt or she's super blunt, and you just can't figure out how to communicate with this person, you wonder, man, what makes this person tick? Why are they behaving this way? Why are they so just direct and seemingly inconsiderate of how a message gets across or what they're trying to teach you, or maybe they're impatient? If you know that they're a D on the DISC, if you've identified this, you're gonna be a lot more lenient in how you treat this person. You're gonna be a lot more generous in your understanding of them and your interactions with them. And they're gonna be that way with you too. Maybe you have somebody on your team and you are leading them and they're that way, but they're a D on the DISC. And you kind of understand why they're so competitive, or why they just want you to get to the point, or why you don't need to over-explain. You know, a D on the DISC probably wouldn't like a micromanager very much. And so if you know the different DISC types of your employees, it's gonna help you interact with them. If you have an eye on the DISC and you're in charge of leading them and you can never get them to hone their focus, you can never get them to make a list or to prioritize things, or if they seem kind of scatterbrained or they're always socializing with coworkers, you can't get them to stay and focus on the task at hand, you're gonna understand why they're that way. And you're gonna understand that they need to have a relationship with you too. They're not gonna be content with just coming to work, punching in, and not having a connection with the people that they hang out with all day. They need to be social, they need to be liked. And then also you're gonna have to solicit their opinion, their honest opinion, and make it safe for them to share it so they tell you the truth. Because an eye on the DISC, if you're leading them, they just wanna fit in. They just want you to like them. They're not gonna necessarily tell you the truth about something that isn't working with your systems or your processes at work, because they wanna be liked. With an S on the DISC, you can't, as a leader, tell them you're gonna do something and then not follow through either. So you can't decide that this policy is in place, and even as something as simple as this piece of paperwork goes here as opposed to here, and then you don't follow through with that, that's gonna matter tremendously to an S on the DISC. They might seem a little bit confrontational about something like that, because you set an expectation of what was going to occur and what the standard was and what the steady environment was, and then you violated it. You had no commitment and consistency, your follow-through wasn't there, and if you don't show them that there are standards and rules and processes that you're going to adhere to, it's going to be really challenging for them to fit in and to see you as a leader that they trust. And then with a C, you need to make sure that you're leading with logic, that you're factual in the way that you set policies and treat people, and you're not emotional as a leader. You're detail-oriented enough as a leader that they admire the organization of things and that they believe in it. And what you can't do when you're leading a C is insult their intelligence. Even if they don't explicitly tell you or show it, that's gonna create resentment. They need to be confident that the person that's leading them is competent. If that's not the case, if you're kind of flying by the seat of your pants, if you're winging it, a C is gonna notice that. It's gonna be very challenging to lead that person. And then you also need to be patient with a C. And if you're maybe an employee at a company and your boss is a C, you need to be patient with them. You know, the person leading you has a hard time making decisions, or they're always wanting to collect more data, or they're slow to pull the trigger, or they seem a little bit fearful even that things might go wrong. The number one emotional response of a C, or the thing that drives them, is fear. They're afraid of making a bad decision. And so if you're leading a C, you have to understand that it's going to paralyze them a little bit when it comes to decision making, because they want to dot their I's and cross their T's and just have things be perfect. And then obviously if you're leading people, or rather you're following a leader that's a C, you need to be conscientious and patient with that too, with them, because a C isn't going to just pull the trigger and make a decision like a D on the disc might. So the benefit of knowing these disc types and being able to recognize the people on your team or your coworkers or your leaders, who they are, what they are, what makes them tick, it's gonna help you interact with them. It's gonna make you more successful in business and in life. Same thing with your customers. If you're able to identify what they are, it's gonna help your interactions with them. If you're in sales, it's gonna help you sell them better. They're gonna have a better experience too. If you're a customer service person, it's gonna help you in your interactions with them, because there's gonna be less frustration just because you've bridged the gap. You understand what makes them tick. And then you're able to properly be proactive and treat them in a way that they wanna be treated. So to wrap things up, we have the four disc types. We have D, which is for dominance. It is 17% of the population. We have I, which is for influential. This is the most common type. It's 38% of the population, roughly. We have S, which is steadiness. These are people that are very stable in their environment, expectations, what they need. They're 32% of the population. And then lastly, we have C. This is conscientious. These are the people that are very, very analytical. They're detail-oriented. It's only 13% of the population, so about 1 in 10 people that you're going to run into. Really, what it comes down to is being able to use these disc types to just have a fundamental foundation for how you interact with people, whether they be customers, whether they be coworkers, whether they be people that you're leading because you're in a management position or a leadership position, whether you be interacting as your talking to the people that are above you in business and in life with others, and being able to identify what they are. It's going to help your communication with them too. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. The goal, of course, is to use these four disc types as your foundation when you're dealing with friends, family, neighbors, coworkers, people you work with, people out in the community, people that you're selling to, people that you're in a customer service situation with, people that are leading you, people that you're leading. Keep these disc types as your fundamental foundation in business and in life, and it's going to help your interaction with others. I really look forward to seeing you guys in the next segment. Until then, cheers.